Morning, everyone. Welcome back to BYT. I am going to try and get the self-etching primer on portions of the bus. I'm going to wipe down the side rails where those, where I got it all down to bare metal. Just real quick, not too terribly. We got a bunch of rain coming later between today and tomorrow. So I'm just going to get a little bit more cleaned up and try to get some of that self-etching primer on some of that bare stuff. So see you in a bit. Here's a little insight on self-etching primer, or any primer for that matter. You have sandable primer, you have self-etching primer, you have self-etching sandable primer. Almost all primers are meant to be sanded, but you have primer fillers. Now, I can feel this edge. This edge has not been sanded enough for a final coat or for a final paint. You can see how smooth this is here. You shouldn't see or feel any of this. Once the primer's on, it should look. You should have a uniform finish all the way down. Let me see, I'm trying to find a spot. I think it's on the other side. But you see a little flake right there. That, I could flake up, knock that paint off. So this is just to protect that bare metal. I only bought two cans to see how this stuff was. And it's doing a good job of covering. I still have to remove all this glue in here and up in here before I can prime this. And no, I'm not, at this point in stage, I'm not worried about getting overspray on my rubbers and on my handles, because everything's going to be cleaned up and taken care of. In fact, it's, over there. But this here, where you can actually see the raised areas inside your primer. You have your smooth areas, then you have your raised areas. This was the center strip. See, I don't know if you can see that on camera. Yeah, there you go. That's the center strip that was between the two stripes. None of this has been final sanded yet. You know, if you look inside here, I have all these little raised areas where I sanded it down, but I left little pieces of paint still on the metal. Well, they weren't sanded down enough. See, most of this is pretty smooth. It all looks one gray stripe, one uniform. And then you get some of these edges just disappear between the yellow and the gray. It just kind of fades. And that's what you're after. When you have this primer on, you should not be able to see any of these lines. So that's what you're after, Case in point, this was behind that reflector. I still have to sand this down. Once again, just trying to protect the metal, the bare metal, incoming weather. So, yeah, is it a waste of primer? Yes, but it's well worth it to protect it from more surface rust that I have to sand off later. I'd rather sand down primer than surface rust. I got these off finally. I'm going to have to come back through here, sand all this down. Eventually, I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to run a straight line across here and trim this anyways. And then box this in, this area from here to here, from the bumper. Especially if I install toolboxes in this area, I will have to frame this with something. So, all right, I will see what I can get into next, and I will let you know. See you in a bit. All right, what I've decided on next is I have all these little protruding pieces off of my ramp. Like these guys. Off each one of my posts. Almost each post has something. Like sharp edges like that. All these little edges. And getting up and down using that as a step ladder I've been catching my clothes on these sharp pieces. I just removed that one right there. So that's my next project, is I'm going to make getting up and down, in and out of the bus from the back here a little bit safer for myself, and start removing these protruding pieces that don't need to be here anyways. So see you in a bit. And I am going through and using all my used cutoff wheels that, you know, have been changed out for various reasons prior to using my new ones. So try to use up as much of the old stuff as I can before I have to go to the new stuff. See you in a bit. Now, there you have a few of them. Now it's starting to rain, so got to get my puppy in. I did get rid of the sharp, pokey edges that were in there. I will put this back up, put my lock back in it. So, yeah, I got rid of all these sharp edges, so I'm getting up and on. I said, you know, these aren't really sticking out where they're catching my clothing. But I'm going to continue working on that, just not today. See you in a bit. All right, everybody. Rain's moving in. Where outside work stops. I will go out later when the rain's heavy. And I will check the leaks in the windows. See water coming in on the floor or whatnot. I know where water should be coming in because of the spots I did not fix yet. So I won't be looking at them areas, but I will be looking at the windows all the way up to the emergency. Like I said, I have not sealed around the glass, so I expect a little bit of moisture in that area. But anything that comes in that glass, you know, should go, well, I guess if it's coming in the bottom glass, it's going to make its way down, so. But we'll find out. If you like today's content, please like, share, subscribe, leave a comment down below. And whatever you're doing out there, you be safe. Have yourselves a great day, and we shall see you tomorrow.